Getting into live streaming on Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, or Facebook is the easiest it's ever been. So if you want to learn how, our tutorial series will get you set up in no time. Let's get right into it. This video is going to cover only the basics you need to start with. In future videos, we're going to dive deeper into the streaming world, but let's get you streaming before we worry about any of that. To start, you first need to join a streaming platform. And if you've come this far, you've probably heard of Twitch.tv. Twitch is a platform where anyone can broadcast or view streams from video games, chat shows, or even live music performances. There's a lot of variety to choose from and to delve into, both as a viewer and a creator of content. While we've mentioned other streaming platforms at the start of this video, we think that Twitch is the best place for you to start out at. So the first thing we're going to do is head over to twitch.tv and make an account. In the top right hand corner, you will see the sign up button. When we click that, a new window should pop up in the center of the screen. Fill this out and hit sign up. Easy. Now, upon signing up, you'll be sent a 6-digit code to the email that you supplied. Stick that in the field here and hit submit. You can also just click the verify button in the email that Twitch sent you. Either way works just fine. Now that you signed up, Twitch will want to figure out a little bit about you, so feel free to choose some of your interests. This can be an array of categories or games or streamers that you already know. Please note that choosing streamers on this window will have you automatically follow them upon completing your 3 choices, if they're one of your choices, of course. Now that you got a Twitch account, you need to know how you'll send your stream to the channel on that account. To do so, let's take a trip to obsproject.com, where you can download a program called OBS Studio. OBS Studio is a free and open source software for both video recording and live streaming, the latter being the one we're interested in. Depending on your platform, select Windows, Mac, or Linux at the top of the homepage. It should begin to download immediately. Now, we want to run through this installation and on the final screen, keep Launch OBS Studio checked, hit Finish. And just like Twitch, there's options for this step, but to start, we highly recommend keeping it simple and starting with OBS. We'll talk more about other streaming software in the future videos. With OBS Studio up and running, we need to connect your Twitch account to this software, so that when you hit Start Streaming, it will direct what's in your OBS Studio feed to your Twitch.tv channel. In OBS Studio, we want to click the Settings button, then navigate to the Stream tab from the menu on the left. In here, make sure Twitch is selected from the Service drop-down menu, and then hit Connect Account Recommended. It's going to bring you to a login screen where you log into your Twitch account again, and it will send you another 6-digit code to your email. Paste in that code and hit Authorize. Check Enable Bandwidth Test Mode and hit Apply, then hit OK. You'll see 2 floating windows left and right of your OBS Studio. Don't touch these for now, but they will come in handy later. Now at the top of OBS Studio, we want to set up the best output you can get from your computer for streaming while not interfering with your own experience of enjoying streaming. So let's go to Tools and click the Auto Configuration Wizard. This basically helps set up the best setting for your stream, taking into account your internet connection and your computer's specifications. Be sure that Optimize for Streaming, Recording is Secondary is selected and hit Next. At this point, everyone will have a lot of opinions and preferences on how to approach this. However, I would recommend just following the configuration wizard through it as you set it up, and then as we go and get an accurate assessment of your computer and internet capabilities, we can make tweaks after a few streams if needed. When the auto configuration wizard has finished testing, it will have determined and estimated the ideal settings for your computer, so let's hit Apply Settings. We can always adjust these settings at a later time. Now you've set up your Twitch account and you've connected it to some streaming software, but there's nothing in your stream except a black screen. So let's cover setting up your audio and video feed. In OBS Studio, click the Settings button again, but this time we're going to head to the Audio tab. In here, you'll find a few sections. The one we want to focus on is the Devices section. For desktop audio, select Default. Ideally, this should be your default playback audio from which you're probably listening to this guide from. This means that anything you hear will come through your default audio listening device to your stream. So if you have your stream on another monitor to check out your chat or just how you look, you'll want to make sure to mute it, or else you'll cause an echo. But also, this means that game sounds, music, or anything else playing on your PC will be broadcast as well. In later videos, we'll go into how to separate sounds and control the mix of your audio, but for now, let's not worry about it. Next, we need to set up your microphone, so let's go to mic/auxiliary audio and select default again. It's best to make doubly sure that both your playback and recording defaults are set to working devices, hit apply, and hit OK. Using default simply means to use whatever audio put is set to your default mic. You could select a specific device, for instance, if your default is a webcam mic, but you have a nice desktop mic, you can select the specific device right here. Just for now, click on the top of each of these windows, the stream information and chat, and then position them over OBS until you see a blue box behind them. Let go and they will click into place within OBS Studio. You can move these anywhere you want inside of OBS Studio or have them floating. It's a personal preference, but for now, we're going to put them here and here. Now we need some video content. Below the main preview window, we have a scene, and in the scene is currently, well, nothing. A scene is a collection of sources, and sources can be anything like your webcam, images, videos, and much more. So let's click the plus button below or right click within the sources window and you'll see this menu. Go to add and in this submenu select game capture, name it whatever you want, but for simplicity right now, I would leave this as is and hit OK. I wouldn't change any settings here, but just to note, once you launch a game and presumably it's in full screen, this source will capture it and display it in your preview window, just like this. Hit OK, then in the sources window, hit the padlock beside the game capture source. What this does is make sure that you don't accidentally click and move the source out of focus or slightly off screen. This is useful for most sources once you've gotten them exactly where you want them to be. If you don't see anything in your preview, then you'll need to open up a game and have it running, or else it won't get captured. Alternatively, if you're not looking to stream a game and you want to stream what's showing on your computer, then you can add a display capture. Adding the source is the same, you'll just select this different type. This will capture anything shown on your monitor that you select. So, as a new streamer, we generally don't recommend this as you'll want to build up your awareness of what's going on during a stream so that you don't accidentally leak a password or a private email. Finally, if you have a webcam, follow the same procedure. Again, only instead of selecting a game capture source, this time you want to select a video capture device source. In here at the top, you'll see a drop-down menu to select a device. Click this and select your webcam and hit OK. It's worth noting that if your webcam has audio activated on it, check the audio mixer window and click the speaker on your webcam's meter. This will effectively mute the audio coming from your webcam, and the only way people will hear you is from your microphone that has audio transmitting. To resize your webcam, you can click on the source and drag the red bounding box down to scale it in the preview window. Then you can click and drag it wherever you like, lock it in place, and that's it. And with that, you're ready to stream. You can click start streaming and get right into things. If you have a second monitor, you can open up your Twitch channel or use the Twitch creator's dashboard to see if things are working properly. Since this will be your first stream, just have fun and see if you like streaming in general. If you do, then make sure to subscribe with notifications on, as we'll be covering what you should look for next and eventually dive deep into advanced topics, setting up overlays, and how to make your next stream the best it can be. Don't forget to drop a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Please leave any comments or questions below, and thanks for watching.